We've made getting set up with VS Code and Slint quick and easy. First, download and install VS Code. Then install the official Slint extension. On the left-hand side, click the extension button, and in the search box, type Slint. Instead of the nightly version, which is a beta, we recommend you install the main version. On initial install, you'll see this welcome screen. Let's dismiss it and create a very simple project from scratch. After selecting Open Folder, we choose a place on the file system for the project, create a folder, give it a nice name, and continue. We will then create a Slint file. It's important to use .slint as the file extension. You can see the file is recognized as it has the correct icon, and the extension is also seeing that there's no content, and offers to add in a Hello World example to get you started. Let's make a bit more room. You can see the Slint extension is providing syntax coloring to help you read the code. Next, any component you're interested in, just click the Show Preview link. Thanks to the live preview, you don't need to install anything else or compile your project. In the editor, when you click an element name, they'll be highlighted with a blue border in the live preview, which can help a lot when your interface is made up of tens of items. Let's look at other standard features the extension has. We delete the About component and instead attempt to add a button. Autocomplete will help you, and not just complete the names of items, but also add in any import statements you need. As the name suggests, Live Preview will update as you make changes. Let's change a color. This also shows the visual color picker that's available for you. Let's see if this button's working. We'll do that with the built-in debug function. Nothing is happening because we haven't got the output window showing. From the terminal menu, select New Terminal, then choose the Output tab, and from the drop-down, select Slint. Now we can see the output as we click the button. VS Code has many features built in for navigating code, but a common issue is that you'll be looking at your running interface and want to jump to the code where it's defined. We've made that easy via the selection tool. Select the tool and then click the element you're interested in. When you have more complex situations with multiple overlapping items, right-click instead. As you mouse over the list, the editor will automatically jump to not just the correct file, but also the specific position that element is defined. When you find the one you want, just click to select it. This concludes our overview of the Slint extension for VS Code.